Hi everyone, welcome again to Skilled Inspirational Academy. Hope everyone is doing good. Keep learning, keep sharing. So here we come with new F5101 exam tips. Previously, the video which we made was for old exam. So now I'm tried my best to make a new video which will help you for 101 new exam materials. So this is help you all beginners who are new to F5 technology and who want to appear for certification. So here we come with tips by Skilled Inspirational Academy. So first of all, I want to tell you all like how these tips will help you and what all materials you can refer to go through and start your journey. So first of all, the first mandatory book to study for 101 exam is by Philip Johnson. So there are two things. One is F5 official study guide, which I will be sharing further on. But if I talk about F5 101 exam book, this is a book which is mandatory. And this will give you a great idea on what all topics are there in 101. And this is compulsory. It's around 333 pages book, and you need to read it and clear the concepts. So this is, I always suggest to everyone to read this book. So you need to go through this link, F5101 Study Guide by Philip Johnson and Stephen Evison. So you need to go to this URL, https://www.f5books.eu.com. So you will find this book. At the end of this session, I will show you the links from where you can get it. You can buy it and start reading it. So this will cover around 13 chapters. So 13 chapters are there on this book. So you need to go through each chapters. You can give 1 hour each day, and it will take around 1 month to clear your concepts. Then you can go to study guide and refer further. So once you've gone through Philip Johnson book, what is your next step? So this is also an important question which have been asking by different students in different social websites, whether it's LinkedIn, Facebook, or YouTube. So once you go through Philip Johnson book, next step is to download blueprint for 101, because F5 paper always come through blueprint. Any other topics other than blueprint will never come. So you need to go through this link and download blueprint. I will show in the last slide, like where to download for 101. So F5 pattern has been changed from this year. And paper has been not online right now. So you have to go to Pearson or ProMatric to give exam. But this blueprint, you need to grab for this. You need to go topic by topic and read the topics. Hope that Philip Johnson book would help you, but you need to go to more details. So suppose if you find any topic which is missing in Philip Johnson, you can type the same on Google from this blueprint and you will find it. F5 documentation is great. So next one, once you go through this blueprint, what's the next step? So you said that you have gone through Philip Johnson book, you have gone through blueprint. Then what is the next step? So next one is the great study guide which has been prepared by F5, and the link for that study guide, which is online, you need to go through this cloud docs.f5.com and just write F5101 search by that, which will very good idea on how things been asked. So the content of this document covers all blueprint for TMOS 13.1. So the exam which will come will be based on TMOS 1 version 13.1. So you need to refer this and you need to practice it. This is a very good link. They have been updating this, and now they have updated 101 on this clouddocs.f5.com. So once you go through this, what are the other tips you can refer? So basically, previously F510 exam was used to be network concept related exam, which was 60% would be from network, OSI, and basic TCP layer, and 40% was for 101. But now they have changed. Now they thought that F5 exams, they should make little bit more advanced. Now it covers 60% of F5 topics, and 40% would be your networking concepts in new exam pattern. So first advice, which all F5 people give, all experienced guys will give, is do not search for exam dumps. Even if it's available, please, please, please don't refer dumps. If you refer, go through the approached way, study hard, you will clear the exam. Do work hard, do study materials, go through blueprint, and you will clear it. And it will help you to clear concepts, it will help you to grow in market, and it will help you to clear more and troubleshoot in your organization. So please work hard, keep sharing, keep learning, and you will clear it. So now here we come with more tips. What are the types? What are the pattern which been asked in F5 exam? This has been taken from the blueprint only. First most important concept is you need to go through OSI layer concept. So you need to know physical layer, data link layer, protocols, what comes under them, network layer, transport layer. So you need to go through all OSI layer model, whether it's a session layer, presentation layer, or application layer. Suppose you access another concept which they ask, they usually ask from OSI layer is packet flow. Suppose when you want to access your PCA, wants to send something to PCB, SWAT, and they are connected interlink with switches, router. So what would be the MAC address and where MAC address will get changed? TCP layer also, please go through the TCP headers in OSI layer. You should know the concept of MSS, MTU. This has been covered in Philip Johnson in very good details. You will come to know what is MTU, what is MSS. Also, this is very important, IPv6. So for IPv6, you can refer omnisecu.com. So you can refer omnisecu.com website, which is very important for IPv6. So they can give you some pattern, you need to convert it. They can ask you about protocols used in IPv6. Another important concept which comes into picture is TCP three-way handshake. So how it flows, they can give you a picture snapshot, like SYN-NAC acknowledgement. So you should know how three-way handshake comes and what comes after three-way handshake. So previous exam does not cover this pattern, EUD and QK view. So now in this blueprint, you should know what is EUD? EUD is basically used to test hardware related concepts. If there is a hardware issue, you need to perform EUD to confirm whether it's an hardware issues related. And what is QK view? So QK view is whenever you open a F5 case, they will always ask you for QK view. So QK view will give you results of all virtual servers and where it is stored and whenever you use this file. This will help F5 tech engineers to troubleshoot further. And you can upload QK view from to iHealth also. So you can use ihealth.f5.com and you can upload QKView and you will see what are the vulnerabilities is there whenever you are upgrading devices. You can see what are the vulnerabilities present in this. You will get it. Another important concept is full proxy architecture of F5. What is full proxy? What is half proxy? And what is reverse proxy? So what is the difference between half proxy, full proxy, and reverse proxy architecture? So full proxy, generally when client connects to F5, F5 maintains another session with server. So you need to know this concept and you will get it. So the generally F5 does not go more in detail in 101, but you should know basic concepts. So F5 more tips continued. So another concepts you should know about UCS, how to save UCS file via CLI command, how you can use it, how can you restore, you should know. So you should know difference between UCS and SCF. So this is also important concept. So you should know difference between UCS and SCF. And how, suppose you do not have GUI, how to save UCS via CLI command. So there is a command to save UCS file. And command is save sys UCS file. Also, this is very important. So you should know color codes for virtual servers. Like what does red diamond does, what does green symbol on virtual server donates. So you should know color coding. If it's a yellow triangle, a red diamond, green circle, what does this color coding? So you can find this article if you search by F5 color coding. Then you will find a great article on f5support.f5.com. Another concept which is very been asked in any interview or in 101 is what is FTP and what is the difference between FTP active and passive. So this is covered in detail in Philip Johnson book. Very good. They have shown through pictures, concepts. So you should know this. Another thing which we covered is you should know they will give you the routing table and they will ask you what would be the next hop to go to the destination. What is the best preferred next hop? So here the concepts comes is like longest prefix match, routing protocol, AD distance. So you need to refer that. This is basic routing concept. You can refer it on Google or you can read from Philip Johnson book. Another concept which has been introduced on F5 in this exam is HTTP status code. So what does 1001XX represent? What does 200 represent? So they can ask you color coding, like they can give you 302. What does 302 represent? Is it redirection? Is it successful or is it informational? So you should go through Philip Johnson book and that it is covered. Another important concept which is been asked in F5 exam preparation is they ask about active standby and active passive scenario HA. So in high availability, what is the difference between active and active passive scenario? So you should know, you can search an HA platform architecture. You can search the video on this channel also. You will get a great detail of HA. Then F5 generally ask about different hardware architecture in F5, whether it's related to VCMP, is it related to virtual edition, VE. So you should know different hardware platform, physical, virtual, and VCMP platform. Also, you should know the sequence number concepts in three-way handshake. So they can give you snippet and you need to identify what is the sequence number. All this is covered in blueprint. Just take the snapshots and just read more detail. Either you can refer omnisecure.com or a TCP basic video concepts. Also, there is one LDAP syntax which you should know, like what is CN, what is OU, what is DC. So you should know this architecture of LDAP. So this is how. So I will cover more tips. So this is basic part one video for F5 tips. Hope start with this video, start with the material which has been referred in this video, and do comments if you need more tips. I will try my best to help you to go through more tips. So you need to know, I will show you some more links which I was referring. So for 201 and 101, there is a link which is f5books.eu.com. So you can refer, you can go to this link, click on F5101 Application Delivery Fundamentals, and you can purchase either from Kindle, Amazon.com, or you can go to paperback.lulu.com. So you can buy it. They will deliver to you at your home. Or you can read on googlebooks.com. So this will only cost you around 500 to 600 rupees book. You can buy it. So another thing which I was referring was F5 study guide. So this was an important. So when you go to clouddocs.f5.com, so you will here see that. You go here. So it will give you unofficial F5 certification exam preparation material. So this was only created in June only. So you can refer that. So there are different articles section wise. And you can see the same on Blueprint. Click on each article and go through that. So it will give you details, articles. So section one is configuration. It will give you everything in detail. This is the best website to get more details on 101 with Philip Johnson. So you can refer that, clear all your concepts. If you still have doubts, you can comment on, you can subscribe my channel, and you can ask, you can email me. We can have some more sessions related to it. Another link which I was referring was how to download Blueprint. So you need to go to this KB article, K29000360. You need to go through this and you need to click on Blueprint PDF. Just click on PDF, you will able to get the downloaded material. This is very important. So first step is download this Blueprint, go through the objective section wise. So section one is configuration, which I was showing on the study guide. So how to configure VLANs, you should know through GUI as well as CLI. So given a scenario, we will go through this Blueprint in next video. We will give you an idea like how to configure it in detail. So section one is basically related to our IP address assignment, VLAN creation, routing, and basic stuffs of what is virtual server, what is load balancer, what is full proxy architecture. So you should go through these details and you should refer it. Section two is troubleshooting. So I was talking about HTTP error codes, TCP handshake, what is the main reason for connection termination. You can get it through TCP dump. So you should know how to perform TCP dump. You should know different packets level, like what is SYN, what is SYNACK, what is ACK, and what is FIN packet. So third step is maintenance. So maintenance would cover, like, suppose someone says that they are able to access URL, but it's getting slowed. So you need to the stats, you need to see the drop packets, increase packets. So you should know statistic tab in LTM. So in next video, I will show you how to check stats in F5. Another scenario, this is very important, how to upgrade So whenever you are going to upgrade F5, what are the main requirements you should refer? So for this, I already uploaded the video for F5 upgrade. What are the important concepts, steps which are needed for F5 upgrade? So another concept is basically related to ICMP, OSI layer, use of TLS and SSL, handshake, SSL offloading. So there are four sections total related to this. And so basically everyone has a question like how much is the F5 exam cost? So F5 exam cost is $180. Previously it was $135. Now they have changed to $180. So F5 exam is 90 minutes long, but if you are non-native in English accommodation, they give 30 minutes extension. What is the passing score? So passing score is 245. So there are around 80 questions, out of which 70 items are scored and 10 are just not scored items. So F5 exams are all multi-choice question exams, and they are all computer-based, either through Pearson and or either through ProMetric. So thank you everyone for watching this video. If you like it, please comment it, please subscribe and share with your friends. Please like it, and I will try to make more videos related to this in detail. We will cover each section in blueprint, and we will cover more. So all the best. Keep learning, keep sharing.